Hello guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. This is Hadidi Makeovers. If you're new here, please don't forget to subscribe. If you're a returning subscriber, welcome back. And also, if you're new here, thanks for subscribing, and don't forget to turn on your notification bell. We do makeup and turban tutorials every Tuesdays and Thursdays. So guys, let's jump right into the video. Today we are going to be doing a melanin transformation look. As you can see, and starting off, I used my Miscella cleansing water, the simple Miscella cleansing water, to clean her face and at the same time toning and hydrating her skin. You want the skin to be well hydrated. If it's not hydrated, then your makeup is not going to last long. I mean, your foundation will not even blend very well. So we are going to be starting off with that, hydrating the skin and also cleaning at the same time. So the next thing here is you want to make sure you the skin is well hydrated one and moisturized, but I'm not going to be using the moisturizer now. I want the face, the micellar water, to settle perfectly on her skin, and then we move. So starting off, I'll be starting with her brows. She already has a full brow, so I'm going to be setting that with powder first, and then going in with the hair guy and Esther brow gel in ebony to highlight, outline the shape of her brows. After outlining, I'm going to go into the sparse areas and just draw some strokes on her brows to make it a little bit fuller. Then I'll be using this my brow tint to tint her brows, making sure the brows look more natural and also look full. If you do this to the brows, it makes it gives it this natural touch that you would not want to resist it. Like, you can't resist the natural touch the brows is going to feel like. Even if you have a sparse brows and you use this brow tint, it makes it look fuller. So moving on, I'm going to be using the concealer in the shade Fawn and Espresso. So I'll be using Fawn, the lightest shade, on her brow bone. Then I'll be going in with the Espresso, the darker shade. That's the Espresso, in the Eyeliner Espresso concealer, to clean off under her brows. So after I'm done with the brows, I'm just going to use my blending brush to blend that out. And then before I do the upper part of the brows, I'm going to be moisturizing her skin. I told you before, I want the skin to be well hydrated. I had to wait a little bit for the micellar water to settle on her skin very well and hydrate the skin properly. So applying the moisturizer, it's also going to wait on the skin. Like, we want to wait a little bit so that it settles perfectly. So as you can see, I am just applying the moisturizer. Now, I don't do primer, guys. I told you, if the model has dry skin, I just do only moisturizer and I move. And the makeup will last very long. Like, and you have to be careful with the way you select your face primer. Some people will not look at the skin type and they'll be selecting a primer that doesn't go with the skin. Some people will just say, okay, this is Pond's or this is Becca primer, or this is this primer, and people think, okay, this primer is not meant for dry skin, and some people use it on a oily skin and all that. So you have to know the type of skin your model or your client has before you use a primer on the person. So mostly I do have you know, in Nigeria here the weather is just anyhow, so mostly the thing I do is I make sure I have a moisturizer with me. Even if the person has oily skin, after you moisturize and you prime, everything just stays perfectly. But mostly lately I have been doing makeup for like dry skinned people, so I tend to just use only moisturizer and then I just move. After moisturizer, I'll just use foundation and then boom, everything sits perfect. From far, I'll just blend, everything will just sit perfectly and then last longer. So I'll be using the foundation in the shade Hot Choco and the Zikel foundation in the shade Cacao to do her face. So the foundation I'm using is the Kalifa foundation in the shade Hot Choco and also the Zikel foundation in the shade Cacao. That's 0030. That is their darkest shade. So if you can look at her skin is not well, it's not like her neck. So I was thinking, even if I go darker, I just felt the foundation is a little bit dark. So I'll just use my concealer to correct the shade. So I'll be using the LA Girl concealer in the shade Fawn and Espresso, the same concealer I used on her brows. I'll be using the Fawn on the highlighted area and the high points of her face. I'll be using the Fawn first under her eyes, the bridge of her nose, and also on her cupid bow and her chin. Then the outer part of under her eyes, I'm going to be using the shade Espresso, just to give it that. I don't want it to be very light, too light, extra light and all that. So yeah. So as you can see, I'm done with blending the concealer. Can you see the face is looking a little bit brighter now? Then I'll be going in with the V Beauty powder palette. I'll be using a lighter shade to set the concealer before I apply the setting powder. And then moving on to the setting powder, I'll be using the Espon setting powder to set her face. But before that, I will have to contour her nose, the side of her nose, just to give it that little boost, that tiny shape that everybody is loving. So after I'm done with the setting powder, I'm going to be applying the eye primer. I'll be using the Benai Clan White eye primer. I'll be applying that all over her crease. So the look I'm going for is something a little bit subtle but yet beautiful. I want it to be subtle just to enhance her beauty more. So let's see. I'll be using the Zikel X Lydia Stanley eyeshadow palette. So before you apply your eyeshadow, most especially if you're going for a matte eyeshadow, you want to make sure you blend the eye primer very well. There is this line that the eye primer tends to have after you apply the eye primer. So before you go in with your eyeshadow, you want to make sure you blend that very well. You want to make sure you blend it smoothly and perfectly, so you see how smooth your eye makeup will look. So using this milk color eyeshadow and then going in with a maroon shade and then blending with a burnt orange color, then everything sits perfectly. Let's see how it turns out. So after I'm done with the eyes blending, I'm going to be using the Mabrook eyeliner, liquid eyeliner, to line her eyes. So, and then after lining her eyes, I used the mascara, the double, the 3X compact mascara. I used that on her lashes, and then to take away the eyeshadow fallout on her lashes and all that. So I'm going to be using the Wink Eyelashes Nigeria in Elsa. I'll be applying that on her lash. Can you see this? And these eyelashes is beautiful, guys. Like, I love this Wink Nigeria lashes. They are super beautiful. Can you see how beautiful it's looking? Yeah, guys. So after that, so the tricky part here is, okay, I'm not using a glitter eyeliner or anything like that. So I use pigment, a silver pigment, used setting spray on my tray, and then sprinkled a little bit of, I sprayed setting spray on the tray, my mixing tray. After spraying setting spray on my mixing tray, I now sprinkle a little bit of pigment. I have this silver pigment from Twinkle, like from the White Glam Cosmetics, and I sprinkled it on top of the setting spray I sprayed on my mixing tray. Then I'm just using this pencil brush to go over the eyes and then lining the eyes. So this is why I told you guys to always watch my videos to the end. I have this tricky idea that I always upload on my videos, and these tips I upload on my videos. So some people will not even know you can do this, like line the eyes with pigment or anything like that. Some people will know can't do this, or some people will have no idea that you can do this. So some people will be thinking, okay, you can use glue to do this and it stay, but I used pigment and only setting spray, and see how perfect her eyes are looking. I wish I could zoom how detailed this thing is going to look, but you see it on the thumbnail. I know you are going to see it on the thumbnail. That might be why you are clicking on this video. So I hope you guys are understanding. If you got to this part of the video, please indicate on the comment section below. Let me know you guys are watching my video up to 18 minutes long. Let me know, guys. You know I love you guys so much. So I'll be moving on to the lips. I'm going to be lining her lips using my brow gel, my random black brow gel that I use every time to line the lips. So I'm going to be outlining her lips. So after outlining her lips, I'm going to be using the Ferrucci concealer palette, this orangey color corrector. I'll be using it on her lips, guys. Can you see how beautiful, like, how she's looking? She looks natural, yet it's looking very glamorous, this makeup. This camera is not doing justice to my work. You guys should watch my videos to the end so I get paid, and then I'll change my camera to give you guys a crispy and more neat makeup videos. So can you see? I'm just using this orangey shade on her lips. You see how it will pop up now. I'll just be using a fluffy brush to brush that off. Like, I want it to be well blended and make the lips look more mattified. I wanted using a gloss on it, but decided to leave it matte. So I'm going to be using her shade of powder from that same UV Beauty powder palette. I'll be taking off the setting powder and setting her whole face with that same powder. So guys, I hope you guys are enjoying this video. I'm not going to be using a blush for this makeup look because I feel I want it to be all brown and dark and all that. So yeah, I don't want to add colors to the makeup because I already used like a very dark shade of powder as her contour, and is also going to be serving as the blush rather. So the Get Gorgeous bronzer is what I'm using to just go over the high points of her face. I hope you guys are loving this video. Then I'll use a setting spray and then boom, that's all guys. So if you love this video, please don't forget to like, don't forget to hit the subscribe button, and also don't forget to turn on your notification bell. This is Hadidi Makeovers. Once again, I love you guys so much, and thank you guys for patronizing me. You've been buying my raw socks, you've been buying all those and all that. So thank you guys for the patronizer. Follow me on Instagram, follow me on YouTube, subscribe to my YouTube channel, follow me on Facebook, Twitter and all that. So I'll see you guys on Thursday for this turban tutorial. I love you guys so much. Bye.